Enzo Recto, kalaban ang katiwalian at kasinungalingan, kakampi sa katotohanan at kabutihan.
I submitted already the copies of the Reuters report to the Honorable Committee. One of the report was done in December 2017. That was the last special report done by Reuters.
Mr. Mugato, you revealed something in the first hearing, no?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, I'd like you to repeat that for the record.
Your Honor, based on our interview with the former intelligence officer, a retired general, Rodolfo Mendoza, he said that he made a written report on the war on drugs, and he listed down, based on the Upland double barrel, as well as the supposed rewards list for policemen who would be able to kill a drug suspect. Basically, 10,000 for an ordinary user. And for some officials like barangay captain or mayor, it's up to 50,000 pesos. That was based on his report. And we cannot confirm his report because that was what he said. And he said that this report was based on his interview with 17 active duty police officers. And so, our editors, at that time...
Did he give the name of the 17 police officers?
No, Your Honor. He did not give the names. But because we still doubted whether the report is authentic, we asked him if he could give us his sources on his report. And he agreed after so many negotiations. And he brought to us one police captain. I cannot give his name because we promised not to reveal his identity. But I can tell you that this police captain is a prison commander, a PCP commander in Manila Police District. And he talked to us in a restaurant in Green Hills, all the details about the so-called drug war, including how the police were able to fake.
You know what the station in the Philippine National Police?
Station 1.
Station po, alam niyo kung ano station?
Station 1, Your Honor.
Police station?
In Tondo. So, he gave to us some details about how the police were able to stage the by-bust operation and the encounters. And most of them were not encounters but execution. Oh? And there were also instances when he said that they were able to remove the CCTV cameras or point away the cameras or put them off so that their activities will not be recorded. And in some instances, when the drug suspects were still alive, they were brought to the hospital. But along the way, these drug victims were shot at close range to kill them. And this was confirmed by doctors we had interviewed that most of the victims were shot at close range because of the tattooing in their bodies and in their head. So, and some of the evidence were also planted according to the police officers. And at one point, he showed us a text message coming from a senior intelligence officer from the NCRPO that requested them to remove their police patrol car in a certain area because they're riding in tandem will pass by that area and they don't want any encounter to happen.
Yeah, ang hirap noon, Mr. Mugato, what you're trying to tell us right now, if you will not give us the names of the individuals, that would be hearsay. And we can put it on record, pero wala magiging patayan dito because you are speaking, you know, without any proof at all, actually.
I'm sorry, Your Honor, but we made a promise to this police officer not to reveal his identity. And as a journalist, we have the right to protect our own sources. Okay. And anyway, all of these were written in a report that is available in the internet.
Mr. Chair, may I lang. Isa lang kaprasa lang ang tanong kaya ng Mr. Mugato. We know your responsibility as a journalist as well. But do you also have this kind of responsibility on the victims? No, hindi ba tayo naawa sa mga biktima natin? By revealing your source, you will able to solve a lot of problems. And I think it is well incumbent upon the journalist that there's this kind of what do you call this selfless act on behalf of the victims as well. So 17 personalities tong sinasabi mo dito eh, mga colonels, captains, major. Sana man lang kahit isa man lang na maibigay mo sa committee na to, I think that will solve a lot of problems. And yung paghihirap ng mga biktimang ito na nakikita natin na naglakas ng loob na pumunta rito para ipakita sa committee that they are so brave, no? In spite of the so many elements of people who are really trying to prevent them from coming, eh sana meron tayong ganitong klase ng nararamdaman sa kanila. So Mr. Mugato, again, kasi nung nakaraang hearing tinanong na kita eh, 'di ba? Sinabi mo hindi kasi kami maniniwala sa iyo eh. Hindi na naman namin talaga paniniwalaan yung sinasabi mo. It will be a hearsay, you know? Pero once na na-reveal mo sa sinasabi mo 17 ito, kahit isa lang, then we will salute you. Hahanga kami sa iyo. Pero hanggang hindi mo sinasabi yan, eh hindi mo kami mabobola dito. No? Hindi ka namin paniniwalaan. So please try to give mercy to these victims of that war on drugs.
I'm sorry, Your Honor, but I cannot really reveal the names of our sources. But I'm telling you,
so kahit
I'm telling this committee that hindi po ako nambabola at base lang po ito sa report na ginawa ng Reuters. So it's up to you to believe it or not, but we have done our duty.
Anyway, are you willing to have a an executive session para at least kahit papano ay maproteksyon na natin yung reputasyon bilang isang journalist to tell us, no? Oh, sama mo, maliwanagan kami doon sa sitwasyon. Kasi meron ka pa rin sinasabi eh, that ang nangyayari, nagkakaroon ng bayaran, di ba? Na 10,000 pesos kapag yung mga robbery, mga swindler, yung mga petty crimes, 10,000 binabayad sa mga polis. At pag mga mayors, mga malamang kasama congressman dyan, or mga gobernador, or kaya mga barangay captain, it's more than 10,000. As a matter of fact, sinabi mo, 50,000 ang halaga. Mabigat na akusasyon yun eh, di ba? And that is according to what you have heard from the 17 personalities that you mentioned. Di ba?
Your Honor, di po namin nakausap yung 17. Ang nakausap namin isa lang na kapitan na dinala nung retired general.
Nung last hearing, sinabi mo yung 17 personalities, I have the record here.
Opo. Yan po ang source ni General 17.
Yung 17. At ang nakausap mo, yung isa, yung kapitan.
Yung kapitan, opo.
Sigurado ka? Kasi the last hearing na andito, sinabi mo, 17 active
penis. 17 po yung kanyang source ni General
Ni General ano, General
Mendoza.
Mendoza. Siya nagsabi sa iyo na may 17 PNP officers that was trying to tell the general na merong ganong klase na bayaran.
Opo. Yes, Your Honor. Pero ang nakausap po namin, isa lang kasi yun lang po ang dinala niya.
Pero okay. yung Kapitan buhay pa, di ba?
Siguro, napromote na po.
Baka Colonel na ngayon yun.
7 years ago eh.
Oo. Anyway, naisiguro mo na yun nasa isang police station sa Manila, Tondo.
Before.
Before. Anong yeri po yun?
2017, April.
Okay.
Sino si PNP during that time?
Si Bato po.
Si General Bato?
General De Rosa.
Oh. Alright. So, the next, I'd like to recognize
Your Honor, just attorney, a matter
Yes. Sorry, Your Honor. Attorney Conte, meron kang gustong ano?
Yes, a matter of information, Your Honor. The document that Attorney Chel Diocnio was referring to, I already put in the presentation at the previous session, Your Honor. The number that appears in the President's 2017 Key Accomplishments reflects 3,967 killed in police operations. This is based on real numbers, PH. This number ballooned to 6,252 po by May 31, 2022.
Attorney Conte, until such time,
yes, sir,
that you're able to convince the others to come out and charge in court on class suit, all of those things that you're saying now are just accusations.
But, Your Honor, these numbers are from a document released by the Presidential Communications Operations Office, which we were also able to independently obtain separately from Attorney Diocno. So this is
yes, a public document. But who is accountable? I mean, you know, sino to accountable dito na charge na ba?
But first, on the point that these numbers are claimed as accomplishments of the President, then perhaps we can establish as that.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, I got also that kind of report that she got right now. And I just photocopy it in from the laptop of Congresswoman Prats. But Mr. Chairman, if I may, you know, kasi I just wanted to question Attorney Diocno. Kasi kanina may sinasabi si Attorney Diocno na 16,355. Diba? Correct ka doon na it was 16,355 and sa year end report ng Malacañang during that time on 2017 it was indeed 16,355 homicide cases under investigation but no riding in tandem that was mentioned. Wala, di ba? But Chairman, it was homicide.
Chairman.
Can you kindly reply on that Attorney John.
Yeah, after you reply, I'm going to recognize Congressman Karab.
Yes, Your Honor. There are two types of killings that occurred during the war on drugs. One type were those who were killed, yung sinasabi po mga nanlaban, killed during police operations, anti-drug operations, by bust, tapos lumaban daw at napatay. The other kind, as we know from the so many reports that came out during that time, ay yung mga nahanap na bangkay na meron nakalagay na sign na drug addict ako, o kaya yung mga napatay na riding in tandem. Yun po yung tinuturing na homicides under
investigation. So in other words, Attorney Diocno, sinasabi mong 6,355 that was mentioned in the year-end report of the former president noong 2017, lumalabas yung 16,335 categorized into two.
16,355.
Na categorized into two.
Yes, Your Honor.
That is correct. So, Attorney Medjadia, will you confirm this report that nakita ko rin sa internet that 16,355 in accordance with the report of the former president, homicide cases under investigation July 1, 2016 to September 30, 2017. Is this correct?
It could probably be correct. It came from the yes. Police, no?
Yes, Attorney Medjadia.
Can we refer that to the Pideya, because they were the ones who gave that figure. That figure. That
sige, Pideya, can we ask the Pideya, please?
Pideya and NBI.
Yes.
Why don't we look on it later, Congressman Fernandez? I'd like to recognize first Congressman Carapps on this.
Okay. Thank you, Chairman. Anyway, Chairman, all those data being presented now, sabi nga ni Attorney, coming from PCC, PCO, how did you get that copy from PCO? Kasi dito, Mr. Chairman, ako ah, kahit yung statement, a while ago, the text being was read by Attorney Jokno, until now that case was still in Supreme Court. And well, in fact, that is just part of the Supreme Court minutes. But until now, it's still in the Supreme Court. The Almora versus La Rosa case. Now, Mr. Chairman, that is why the time then PNP Chief de La Rosa is being represented by OSG, in which that is Attorney Kalida now. And he's not present today. That's why, again, I'm reiterating that he should be present in the next hearing. Now, those documents, even the data read by the good chairman of public order and safety, is not an official data, because the only official data that should be given to us should come from the office itself. Well, in fact, if you remember, Mr. Chairman, and I think I have to check the COMSEC, during the first hearing, I asked the Honorable Committee to the Chair for us to request to the office of the ES now and to the office of the President the executive summary submitted by the then DOJ Secretary Guevara and now OSG, because that is an official document. And well, in fact, Mr. Chairman, on record, Almora versus De La Rosa, that was cited by Attorney Jokno, OSG never complied to submit that document.
Bunyog, bunyog, halika na kasama ka. Bunyog, kapag buklod ay may pag-asa. Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, isa ang pananaw. Sa bagong Pilipinas, ang bunyog isisigaw.